It felt like doing a mission trip in Cincinnati.
I'm overwhelmed. I'm really amazed because I've never seen this.
Never.
I've never seen this. I've never seen anybody do this, and I'm amazed.
It's just amazing. I didn't think that people actually did that. Actually cared about each other. So it's kind of, it's refreshing.
This is wonderful. I mean, this is the most beautiful blessing that anybody can have because we're going through such a hard time now.
I was smiling. Smile is free. You know what I'm saying? I was smiling.
They gonna sit in my praise that this was just awesome.
Yeah.
You know, amazing. It was just a blessing.
And I come in and y'all, open hands. Come on in. I'm like, thank God.
Wow.
So, God was on my side.
Yes. We need to do this again next year. It's been a lot of work, but it's been just beyond fulfilling for me. I don't even... This is really why I do dentistry.
I'm Eric Hennies. This is Dentistry from the Heart. On September 24th, 2011, we are providing free care for members of the community who otherwise couldn't afford it. It was a concept I actually read about in a couple of dental journals. A gentleman in Florida, a dentist in Florida, actually started the concept. And we had also seen a video at a continuing education class that we went to of another office that did one of these events. And I think everybody that saw that just said, wow, wouldn't it be cool if we could do that in our community? And so we talked about it and we visioned about it and eventually we just said, you know, we're gonna do this, but only if all of us in our practice team really feel like we wanna do it.
Jessica Fields, I'm the practice administrator for Dr. Hennies and Dr. Moorhead, and we decided that we were going to do this event to give back to the community about 6 months ago. It took us a little while to come up with a date, and we had about 4 months to plan, which is not a lot of time to plan when you're planning something this large. Fortunately, we had Dr. Hennies' daughter, Hillary, here from college, and she was a big part of getting everything rolling. A lot of us were here at 6. To just get tables set up and chairs because it was raining yesterday and we didn't want to leave them out. But most everybody was here by 6:30, 7 o'clock, and
the doors open.
We started registration at 7, and I think we had our first patient back ready for care around 7:30, quarter till 8.
Wow.
So we started earlier than we expected.
Hi, I'm Trisha. I'm from Dr. Hennies' dental office. Dr. Hennies and Dr. Moorhead are going to be providing free dentistry for people in Cincinnati area with an event called Dentistry from the Heart. We've been here since about 6 o'clock this morning, and we've had patients patiently awaiting to be able to receive free treatment for either a cleaning, an extraction, or a filling. We're going to take you inside and show you the different stations so you can see what we've been going through. Starting out, we have registration where people get their blood pressure and they fill out their paperwork and they get to meet wonderful volunteers like Rick, who gets to talk to them and share with them about whatever their needs are. And then we bring them on inside. Let's go this way.
My name is Rick Rogers, and my involvement with this activity is the result of being a patient of Dr. Hennies. My responsibility has been pretty much hosting individuals, so as they go through the administrative process, making sure that their questions are asked. When their number is called, because everybody's assigned a number. I know them all very well with numbers, I just don't know their names. We make sure that they know to come in and understand that initially they'll get an x-ray, then they'll be asked to leave, and then we'll call their number again so that they can come in for triage or for a cleaning or one of the procedures that are being offered.
So we've had over about 80 different volunteers, including patients and people from the community that have helped us out. We went down to about 17 different locations and churches to invite people to come to this event. And we've had probably, hopefully about 100 people to 150 will be able to treat altogether if we're lucky. Let's go inside. So we start out bringing patients in. They get a chance to decide what kind of procedure they want to have done. If they decide they're going to need a filling or an extraction, we bring them over to this side, which is the triage in the anesthetic area, and they get a chance to find out what's going on and see how they can best be served by the different dentists that are in the area. We have a lot of dentists that have volunteered to help out, as well as the doctors that are part of this practice.
Trying to keep it loaded.
There's my TT.
And they come back, they get a chance to visit with one of our wonderful dentists. And here we have the fillings and the extractions being done by specialists like Dr. Stastny and Dr. Harris. After they get done with their filling, we're going to go ahead and go to the next side. Then we just bring them out, or if they get their extraction, we'll take care of them and bring them out as well. But then some people just want to get their teeth clean, so they would come over this way. Of course, everybody gets an x-ray done, which is, this is where they get their panoramic. And they come in here, and hey, Danae. And they come in here and they go ahead and get their teeth cleaned. Once they're done with their cleaning, we're going to bring them back out to the front. Of course, we have Crystal, who's in sterilization. She's an awesome, awesome representative from one of our major dental suppliers. And then they're done, they come out here back to meet Kathy or whoever is here at registration. They get some follow-up forms, they get a gift. Some people have won a lot of door prizes, but they always walk away with some instructions and definitely a toothbrush and a floss to take care of themselves when they go home. That's it.
My name is Doug Moorhead. I'm one of the dentists that works here in this practice. Owned by Dr. Hennies, but I work alongside him here. So. And yeah, the day is going awesome. We've had a great turnout. It's actually our first year, so we didn't want to have too many people. But at the same time, we wanted to have enough people to where this could be a productive day and help a lot of people. So I think we got the word out to just the perfect amount, so we're not overwhelmed, you know.
I'm John Hellman. I'm a general dentist. I actually went to school, dental school, with Dr. Hennies of Ohio State, so I've known him 30 plus years. As far as what we did today, I thought this was great. I've talked about doing things like this with friends in both the dental and the medical field, and I give those people all the praise in the world to go to Haiti or some other country, but I'm thinking, if we can do this kind of stuff over there, why not do it here?
My name's Tiffany. I've been working with Dr. Hennies for about 4 years, and I'm a dental assistant. For me, this was the first big like charity event I've ever done. And so it was like, wow, I really have a heart for this kind of thing. You know, it's like, I love helping people, you know, in need.
It felt like doing a mission trip in Cincinnati, and the bonding between all of the teammates, even and the volunteers, was similar to when you go away on a trip and you have this great experience and you come back and you just kind of are on this high because you really feel like you did something different in someone's life that they appreciated more than the average person.
I was mostly inside, and for me, I worked with a lot of assistants in school and some getting ready to graduate, and that was different, but it worked really well. I was at first like, oh my gosh, how is this all gonna, you know, play out? But they jumped right in there, you know, excited to do extraction, things they've never done before. So in my area, it was great.
Yeah. You see a lot of people who have been putting off treatment for a long time because, you know, they either lost their dental insurance or don't have means to pay for services. So a lot of people have very broken down teeth that are abscessed, a chronic infection going on in there. So we have mainly been extracting those bad teeth, but we also have done quite a few fillings as well. But extractions are a huge need, and so it's been going great.
You know, there are people that are living with chronic pain in their mouths just day in and day out because they can't afford to go to the dentist. They don't know how to take care of the problem or whatever. But so if we could even help one person like that, let alone 10 or 20 or 100, then that would be worth it.
We value them as people, and you know, we want to take care of them. And to be able to bring somebody in and remove a tooth that's been hurting them for 2 or 3 years is just, you know, it's just great. It's awesome to be able to do that for people.
I love dental hygiene, but to be able to love dental hygiene and serve people in a way where it's not about production, it's not about anything that has to do with money. It's all about completely 100% giving back.
Each tooth extraction is usually a couple hundred dollars, so if you're helping out 100 people with extractions, that adds up quick. And then fillings, I don't know, we'll have to look at the end of the day, but probably tens of thousands of dollars, I'm sure.
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you think it's worth it?
Yeah, of course. I mean, just trying to treat other people the way we want to be treated. We're in the same situation, so.
Fortunately, you actually receive more than you give. There's no question.
There was a familiarity that had to take place, and roles and responsibilities had to be learned. But everybody was here for all the same reason, which was to convey love and a desire to help others that were in need. And so it was all done with a positive expression, and I think went very, very well.
And I know I changed people's lives today, and it was very rewarding. So it was neat to be able to, I mean, I remember people's names, I remember their stories, and I just connected in a way that was what it's all about.
It's 5 o'clock this morning, I'm getting up, and I had this little voice and telling me, oh, I'm tired, I just want to go back to bed. And then this voice kicked in and said, nope, this is too important, your sleep is not worth it, get your butt up.
Yeah. I listen to her, so.
I heard about this the fire they put in our doors, and so me and my neighbor decided to get up early this morning because I been having a tooth that I needed to be pulled, and I've been putting it off because I lost my job and stuff, so this was the perfect opportunity to come in there and get it out.
I thought it was a gimmick. Like, they're going to get you in there, and then they're going to, oh, well, you know, it's $1,000. But I've been on my phone outside reading about, on the website, reading about the organization, how long it's been around, like what they do, going traveling the country, and it's just amazing. I didn't think that people actually did that, actually cared about each other. So it's refreshing.
I was having such a problem with this tooth. And as I said, I don't have any insurance or any kind of way to pay for it. And the blessing just opened up. You know, it was on TV this morning. And I was like, wow, you know, this is like unreal. So when I was driving down here, I really still didn't believe it. And then I got here and I just saw the, you know, everything that was going on, and it was so good. was so good.
I was working at the time and I cracked my tooth and I'm like, I just started this job. And I said, I don't have no money to get my tooth together. And while I was working in Fairfield, people was telling me there's a thing going on in Blue Ash about getting your teeth together. I said, are you serious? They said, the first 100 people. I said, it's 11 o'clock. I said, I'm not going to make it.
I don't think people would get up that early to come to the dentist of all places. Like, I can see getting up early to go to King's Island, but not for the dentist. That's not fun.
You run into a problem or a situation where your teeth start to go on you, and you need that extra help. And for you all to reach out like this to the public is such a beautiful thing. It shows how much of a caring heart you all have and just how much love for people you have, which you very seldom see outright in the world today. Everybody's just so wrapped up with themselves and everything else that, you know, you tend to forget your neighbor, the other people around you. And it's not like they mean it, you know, not like they mean it. It's just, you know, everybody's so weighed down, but you all have done such a beautiful thing.
But I need to make money because people need to eat. And I said, well, most likely they're going to be full when I get off, which is at 3:00. But I still looked it up and found it, and I said, well, it's probably over, but I'm not going to discard it. Let's give it a try anyway. And I come in, and y'all, open hands, come on in. I'm like, thank God.
Wow.
So God was on my side today.
This is really helping people who need help. If you've ever had a toothache, and you know when you have a toothache, no denying that pain.
I had a tooth pulled 2 years ago, but they pulled the wrong one. So now I'm stuck with a tooth that needs to be pulled, but I don't want to go back to the same person because I pulled the wrong tooth.
It's terrible.
So, yeah, it's a bad experience there.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'm around a bunch of smokers, so, you know, when I smile around them now and I don't have that little yellow stuff all over my teeth, they're going to be like, Lee, did you brush your teeth today? You know, just trying to be funny, like I don't brush it every day. I'm like, no, you know, I came up here to the dentist and I got it done. And they're going to ask me where. And, you know, they're probably going to come up here, but it's too bad because it's not free anymore. So they won't be smiling.
This is wonderful. I mean, this is the most beautiful blessing that anybody can have because we're going through such a hard time now.
Yeah, we'd like to say thank you so much. And God bless them and their families for all the hard work they do. Appreciate it. I really do. Because I don't have health insurance and I really appreciate it. I really do.
Some guy hit me from the back. So that's like took me out of my job because they said I can't perform my job duties any longer. So I still get unemployment every 2 weeks, but that's just not enough to take care of me and 6 kids. So I have to wait around so I can find something free for myself because they won't even give me medical coverage at Jobs and Family Service. So when I found out about the free event for your teeth, I said, hey, I'm going to be there. So that's fine.
What number were you?
Number six. And that number six, it means a lot to me.
Why is that?
Because my son died in a car accident in May 1998. And he played football for Sycamore. He was number six. So my license plate says six. His name was Dominic, so it says six, Dom. So when I got number six, I'm like, oh, I got number six. You know, and that probably would mean a lot to everybody, but six means something to me because it was his number on his jersey. So this is amazing.
The 24th, when I got that on my doorstep or in my door, it set a goal for me. You know, on the 24th, that's when I'm gonna stop smoking. Period. You know,
wow.
Because smoking builds up, you know, plaque and all that. So I don't want to do that anymore. So
I just want to thank them for being obedient to God, what He put on their heart to do this for the people, and just thank them and just tell them just keep on with the good work. I mean, because this don't happen often. So we know where it comes from. When things like this happen, when people come together like this, it's only coming from a heart of prayer, and that's God. And I just want to just thank Him.
But I greatly appreciate all of y'all. And God's got you.
Yeah.
He's got us all. He's got us all. So to everybody, remember this. Keep a smile on your face and always keep walking with grace.
This is such a blessing. And even though, again, I'm not receiving services, but the people that this is helping, it's priceless. I mean, truly, this is a ministry. Truly, God put this on your heart to do, to open up your business, to, you know, get volunteers to come. Everybody is giving up their time. You are truly being a blessing to the kingdom and even to those who don't know Christ. And this could be that avenue where, you know, just in thinking they're coming to get some dental work done, but you never know what word will be spoken into that life and might make that difference, because it's all about salvation and it's all about Him. And I thank God for your faith and allowing the Lord to use you like this, because you are blessing many.
Wow.
And that's what it's all about.
That's what it's all about.
That's what it's all about.
Talking up all night, saying things we haven't for a while. We're smiling, but we're close to tears. Even after all these years, we just now got the feeling that we're meeting for the first time. Oh.